Cybersecurity jobs may fall or stall out in the future, and in this video, I'm gonna go over some reasons why I really think this might happen. And this might come across a little bit weird, since I actually work in this career field myself.
Ironic. He can save others from death, but not himself.
If anything, I would want cybersecurity jobs to grow in the future, but guys, this just might happen. This might be the reality for us. For those of you guys who are actually working in cybersecurity right now, or are looking to get into cybersecurity, just keep this in mind. In the next 25 years or so, this could kind of slow the growth or make the growth actually decline in the future for cybersecurity jobs. So I'm gonna go ahead and jump into it. Again, this is my own opinion. I'm gonna be talking about blockchain. I'm not an expert in any of this stuff. So go ahead and claim how wrong I am. I do know I'm wrong a lot. So just go ask my wife, she'll tell you all about it. So if you guys don't know what blockchain is, in a nutshell, blockchain is a data structure that holds transactional records, ensuring security, transparency, and decentralization. So transactions could be any sort of data that's moving. So for us who are in IT.
Yes, I love technology.
We know that a lot of data that's in transit, you know, you're talking about credit cards that are swiped, that are sent, you know, that data, all that data that's in transit, that's what the meat of everything is, and ensuring that basically with a million different methods of IT security. So this is just a huge thing. So if it's ensuring that, that's kind of simple. Many cybersecurity jobs are all about compromising or defending a weak point in the network. But if they're all tied to one network, I find it 1,000 times harder to hack this, because basically you're removing all those weak points in the system. For you to hack my one laptop, now that could be a lot easier, but with blockchain in the mix, you have to basically hack this computer, my other laptop, my name, like all part of that blockchain network. So you'd really have to compromise the whole blockchain network to compromise one system. There would basically need to be flaws in the blockchain or integration itself of blockchain with the system, possibly the way it's configured or set up on this. But that is definitely another way that blockchain can help. Blockchain has abilities of verify infrastructure. So let's say if there's a misconfiguration, maybe an IP address is wrong or a firmware is out of date or something like that, some sort of misconfiguration, blockchain will really actually be able to verify that that is good to go. Really what we're talking about with cybersecurity is the weakest link is actually people. We're always kind of defending or trying to, if you're on a red team or something like that, you're always trying to find those weak links, and usually it's just people who are the weakest link.
Why are you the way that you are?
Whether it's a common misconfiguration they find out about, or if it's just people being dumb with their privacy, whatever it is, I mean, we're really talking about people here on the weakest link. But blockchain and the rise of automation can actually really diminish a lot of those weak links. That's a great thing for IT security as a whole. But when we're talking about cybersecurity as a career, a lot of those jobs are actually pretty focused on covering up what other people have been doing, basically going through different logs and data and stuff like that, and just making sure that everything checks out. So when we're talking about cybersecurity as a job and a career itself, it really might hurt the industry, because a lot of our daily job duties might be really minimized. So when we're talking about data in transit, or any sort of misconfigurations that are set up, blockchain really does have the abilities to kind of integrate itself with any sort of protocol to be able to really minimize those. Again, guys, this is just my opinion, so I don't claim to be an expert in blockchain. Maybe there's some big flaws that I don't know about yet.
Right, I'm right, and when I'm wrong, I could have been right, so I'm still right because I could have been wrong.
But from what I'm telling, this is just a technology that is growing, and it's getting stronger and better by the day. And in my opinion, it's really going to change at least cybersecurity as we know it and what the job functions are. A lot of it is remediation, right? So if you work in cybersecurity, you know this. Remediation, basically going through things that have a weak point that have been found out or are just outdated, stuff like that. So it's going back through those and remediating any of those weak points that we have. With blockchain though, and machine learning, we really are going to have probably a significant change in the future. Now this change can really probably take a little while. I'm not talking about today or tomorrow or even the next 10 years. It might not even be around 10 years, but I think in the next 25 to even 50 years or so, maybe as soon as 15 years, really, we're gonna see a big change and kind of a shift of IT security or cybersecurity jobs. A lot of these cybersecurity jobs might actually shift towards like blockchain developers or blockchain security engineers or something like that. But I think those jobs have actually started to come out, and they're probably gonna continue to be on the rise big time in the next 25 to 50 years. Again, this is just my opinion. One other wild card I wanted to talk about is quantum computing. With that becoming more and more common, that could definitely play a huge factor in attacking or the defense of different networks. So we're talking about quantum computing, you're talking about a ridiculous amount of resource, you know, ones and zeros actually happening at the same time. So I would say that that's definitely a wild card there. Maybe there's going to be more resources on one side than the other, so we might see more attacking or defense. I don't know. That's just one wild card I would definitely have to point out with what I'm saying here. And of course, there's always going to be vulnerabilities that require human backing. But I would just say again that this would probably change in the future, as there's going to be definitely more AI and blockchain technologies that are really just going to be able to wrap this up for about 90% of us. With one job going away, there's definitely going to be a growth of another sector with blockchain coming out and just starting to gain more traction here in 2020, 2021. A lot of these jobs become more mainstream. We're going to see probably blockchain being taught a lot more in future education and just becoming more mainstream for us. So that's definitely a good thing, because blockchain has this huge perks and it's really just going to improve IT in general. Packs and stuff costs a lot of money every year for companies. So I definitely would say that this is a good thing in general, but for our industry, for cybersecurity careers and IT security careers, this could really change a lot of things for us. We might see a lot of these protocols, such as DNSSEC or pretty much anything you can think of, that will probably start to integrate and adapt to blockchain technology and actually run on blockchain supported infrastructure. And so that means that a lot of these technologies are just going to have flaws that existed in the past but are just not really going to be possible as they were back then. So I just wanted to come on here today and talk a little bit about that. I'm definitely not like scared, because I think this is going to take a little while. We have plenty of time to figure out what we want to do. And I would just say though that if you want to do anything right now, I would just start researching more about blockchain and kind of how it actually will affect our future lives. Read up on what I'm saying here, because I do think that this is a change that's going to come to us. People who are getting into cybersecurity or are working in cybersecurity should just be aware about that. Way they're just not caught off guard when cybersecurity jobs start to decline, or they have a hard time getting one in the next 25 or 50 years. So that's pretty far out. So anyways, guys, I appreciate you watching this video. Go ahead and leave a comment below what you think might happen in the future, how that's going to look like. And just if you have any other comments about this, if you have any other questions, IT questions related, or just business IT, anything like that, guys, I really do appreciate your support in this channel. Go ahead and leave a like and subscribe below. And thanks for watching. Have a good one. Bye.